Hi guys and welcome back. So while I was doing the testing of my little pumpkin doll, I did a side project and I tried to make a reversible doll with a bat and a vampire. So here's the pattern ready for you. It's perfect for Halloween and really easy to follow. So let's get started. So here are all the supplies we need for this project. We're going to need some yarn for the head of our little vampire. Then you're going to need something for the rope as well as the body of the little bat. I'm going to be using purple. You can use brown, gray, any color you like. Then you're going to need some black yarn for the cape. You're going to need some pink yarn for some detailing, 4 pairs of safety eyes, a stitch marker, some stuffing, a pair of scissors, and along with this yarn I'm going to be using a 2.5 millimeter crochet hook. And the reason why I'm using that is because most of these scraps are Elise cotton gold, which is a fine or a sport weight 3-ply yarn, so 2.5 millimeters works the best with it. If you use a bigger hook or thicker yarn, then your project is just going to be much bigger than mine. So now let's get started with the head of the doll. So we're going to start with a magic ring. Hold the yarn in your fingers like this across 2 fingers and create an X at the back of your fingers. Now insert your hook into the bottom, pick up the top and twist, and then just pull up a loop. So you have a magic ring ready. Now into this magic ring we're going to place 6 single crochets. So insert your hook, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through 2, and do that 6 times. 3, 4, 5, 6, and then just tuck the tail end tightly to close up your magic ring. Now for row 2, you're going to place 2 single crochets into each of the stitches all the way around, or an increase. So into the first one we've placed 1 and 2, into the next one again 1, 2, into the one after that 1, 2, and you're going to do this 6 times all the way around until you had 12 stitches for this row. Now I've just placed a stitch marker on my 12th stitch to keep track of my rows. Now for the next row, we're going to place 1 single crochet followed by an increase. So 1 in the first stitch, 1 and 2 in the second one, again 1, followed by 1 and 2 in the same stitch, again 1, and then again 1 and 2 in the same stitch. And you're going to do this 6 times all the way around till you have 18 stitches for this row. Now for the next row, we're going to place 2 single crochets followed by an increase. So 1 in the first stitch, 1 in the second stitch, into that third stitch you're going to place 2, and you're going to do this 6 times all the way around until you have 24 stitches for this row. Now for the next row, you're going to do 3 single crochets. So 1 in the first stitch, 1 in the second stitch, 1 in the third stitch, followed by 2 single crochets or an increase in the fourth one. You're going to do the 6 times all the way around until you have 30 stitches for this row. Now for the next 4 rows, you're just going to place 1 single crochet all the way around for 30 stitches for each of the rows. So once you finish the next 4 rows, meet me back here again. So now I'm done with my repeat rows and this is what it looks like. Let's go ahead and add the safety eyes right now. So I'm going between rows 7 and 8. I'm going to place one of the eyes, then count about 5 stitches and then place the other one. Once I'm happy with the placement, I'm just going to attach the safety backing at the back. Now for the next row, we're going to do our first row of decreases. We're going to do 3 single crochets followed by a decrease. So that's 1 in the first stitch, 1 in the second stitch, 1 in the third stitch. Now to do an decrease, you're going to split the next stitch. So if you see there's a V right here, we're going to split the V into 2. Just go into the front loop, then we're going to go into the next stitch, split it up, go only into the front loop, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2. Let me show you that again. 1, 2, 3. Let's do a decrease. Let's split this stitch, go only into the front loop, split the next stitch, go only into the front loop, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2. Now you're going to do this 6 times all the way around until you have 24 stitches for this row. Now for the next row, we're going to place 2 single crochets followed by a decrease 6 times all the way around for 18 stitches for this row. So again, to do a decrease, split the first stitch, split the second stitch, yarn over, pull through 2, and yarn over, pull through 2. Now for the next row, we're going to place 1 single crochet followed by a decrease 6 times all the way around for 12 stitches for this row. Now before we go on to the next row, let's go ahead and add some stuffing to the head. So make sure that you stuff the head properly. If you overstuff it, the yarn will start poking through the stitches, so make sure you don't do that. Just put enough stuffing to give it shape. Now for the next 2 rows, you're just going to place 1 single crochet all the way around for 12 stitches per row. So complete the next 2 rows and I'll show you how to proceed. So now at this point, let's do a color change, and the best way I find to do a color change is just undo your last stitch. So you still got your 2 loops on the hook, you haven't done the yarn over and pull through. Now you take the new color, which for me is going to be the purple, and I'm going to just attach the new color in front of the old one like this and pull it through. Now I'm just going to tighten the old color, leave a tail, snip it off. And now for this row, we're just going to place 1 single crochet all the way around for 12 stitches for this row, but this time in the new color. And what we're going to do is, rather than doing a regular single crochet, we're going to do a back loop single crochet. So it's a little small, I'm not sure if you'll be able to see it, but if you see, each of the stitches has the V. We're going to go only into that back loop and place a single crochet. So that's 1, split the next stitch, back loop only, 1, split the next stitch, back loop only, and go ahead and do that for the entire row. Now for the next row, you're going to place 1 single crochet followed by an increase 6 times all the way around for 18 stitches for this row. Now for the next row, you're going to place 2 single crochets followed by an increase 6 times all the way around for 24 stitches for this row. Now for the next row, we're going to place 3 single crochets followed by an increase 6 times all the way around for 30 stitches for this row. Now for the next row, we're going to place 4 single crochets followed by an increase 6 times all the way around for 36 stitches for this row. Now for the next row, we're going to place 5 single crochets followed by an increase 6 times all the way around for 42 stitches for this row. Now for the next 20 rows, you're just going to place 1 single crochet all the way around for 42 stitches per row. Now once you're done, this is what it should look like. You can just snip off the yarn and then hide the end. So now we're going to make a little cloak for the vampire. This is completely optional, you don't have to do it, but I think it gives a very cute look to the vampire. So I'm starting with a slip knot. Now I'm going to chain 15. So now once I'm done with my chain of 15, I'm going to go into the third chain from the hook. Skip the first one, skip the second one, go into the third chain, place a half double crochet, and then 1 half double crochet all the way around until the end. So you'll have 13 half double crochets at the end of this row. So now for the next 2 rows, you're going to chain 2, turn your work around, and then just place 1 half double crochet into each of the stitches till the end of the row. So now for the next row, we're going to chain 2. So 1 and 2, I'm going to turn my work. I'm going to slip stitch into the next 3 stitches, so that's 1, 2, and 3. Into that 4th stitch, I'm going to place 2 half double crochets, and then place 1 half double crochet until the last 4 stitches. So now I'm at my last 4 stitches. In the last stitch right here, I'm going to place 2 half double crochets and then just leave the rest of the stitches as it is. Now chain 2, turn your work, place 2 half double crochets into that first stitch, 1 half double crochet until the end, and then 2 half double crochets in the last stitch. So I'm at that very last stitch and I'm just going to place 2 half double crochets. So now what we'll be doing is we've created a collar and now the cape will start fanning out. So now for the next 6 rows, you're just going to keep following this pattern, which is you're going to chain 2, turn, place it increase in the first stitch. You're going to place half double crochet increase, then 1 half double crochet till the end and 1 half double crochet increase at the end as well. So complete the next 6 rows and then I'll show you how to proceed. So now I've done about 6 rows of increases and this is what it looks like. Now I'm happy with this length. So going forward, I'm just going to place 1 half double crochet all the way around until the end. So the pattern is going to be chain 2, turn your work and then just do 1 half double crochet until the end. And you're going to do this till you've reached the entire length of your doll. So I'm going to finish the next couple of rows and I'll show you what it looks like. So now once you're done, this is what it should look like. And the way we're going to assemble it is that this slightly longer portion on top is going to form the collar. And then we're going to have the cape at the back. So let me show you how to assemble this. So before we attach the cape, we're actually just going to flip this over. If you remember, we did work on the head and the neck, but then we didn't close this up. So what we're going to do is grab some purple yarn and then just do a simple stitch across the first row of purple stitches, just going back and forth and sewing these two ends together. So now once you've sewn it together, this is what it looks like. You can just hide the ends. Now we can work on sewing the little cape on. And for that, first you have to just place your doll in place. Make sure that the collar is at the neck right here. And then we're just going to sew it onto the back. So make sure that you separate the front and the back, otherwise your doll will get sewn shut. We don't want that. And then just do a simple stitch to attach the cape to the clothing. So I'm doing this in purple because I don't want the stitches to be in black on the other side, on the side of the bat. You can choose to do this in any color you like. So now once you attach the cape, this is what it should look like. Now what we're going to do is we're going to even stitch the bottom of his little rope to the bottom of the cape so that we can reverse the doll easily. We're not going to stitch up the sides right now because I need to add safety eyes on the other side and I want to hide it in between the two layers. So for now, all we're going to do is just go into the front of the cape and the back of the robe and stitch these two together. So you just do a simple stitch and attach these two together. So with this, we're complete with the vampire side and now let's flip it over and start working on the other side. So this is going to be our base for the bat. Now we're going to add some eyes, a snout, some ears and some wings. So now the first thing that we're going to do is attach the safety eyes. So pick wherever you want to place the eyes. I'm going to choose a spot right here for one. And then the other one about 5 or 6 stitches away, like that. And if you see, since we didn't sew in that side, I can still push my finger in and attach the safety eye. So you can attach the safety on both sides using that little space that you have in between the cape as well as the robe. So this is going to be a little difficult, but let me try to show you how I attach the backing of one. So I've split up the back side because we didn't sew in the sides and I can go ahead and push the backing in place. Now we can work on a little nose for the bat. So go in the middle of the eye stitches a few rows below, and then just take some pink or red yarn that you have, any scrap will do, and just go over two stitches 3 or 4 times. Once you've made the nose, you can go ahead and hide the edges inside. Now once you're done with this, you can just create a small smile for your bat. So I'm doing this with some black yarn. I'm just going to do a simple stitch through the front and the back, and that makes a little smile. We're going to add some teeth, so you don't need to stitch this down. We're going to do it with some paper and add some glue, so this is just going to get stuck. You can hide the ends on the back side. So now what I've done is I've just cut out little triangles of paper that look like this, and then just added some regular school glue, white glue, and just pasted it around the smile. And this is what it looks like. It's going to take a while to dry, so just don't mess with it for some time. So now since I gave the little bat some fangs, I decided to give my little vampire fangs too. But this time I used a red pen and just colored the white paper in red before I stuck it on. So now we can start working on the ears. We're going to start with a magic ring. And into that magic ring, we're going to place 4 single crochets. Now for row 2, you're going to place 1 single crochet followed by an increase 2 times all the way around for 6 stitches for this row. Now for the next row, you're just going to place 1 single crochet all the way around for 6 stitches for this row. Now for this row, we're going to do 2 single crochets followed by an increase 2 times all the way around for 8 stitches for this row. Now for this row, we're going to do 1 single crochet all the way around for 8 stitches for this row. So now once you're done, this is what it looks like. You can just leave a long tail for sewing in, snip this off, and then make a second ear. Now once you're done, you should have 2 little triangle ears that look like this. Now to sew this on, what we're going to do first is, we're just going to fold the ear a little bit on the bottom. And then just stitch it across. It's just going to be 1 or 2 stitches, just to give it a little bit of shape. Now once you're done, just shape it a little with your fingers. Go on either side of the little head and do a stitch across. Now once you're done attaching the ears, this is what it should look like. So now let's work on the wings. You have to make a slip knot and then go ahead and chain 10. Now from the third chain from the hook, skip the first 2, go into the third one and place 1 half double crochet until the end. So you're going to have 8 half double crochets. For the next row, you're going to chain 2 and turn. And then place 7 half double crochets. So once you're done with your 7 half double crochets, you'll notice there's 1 stitch, but we're not going to do a half double crochet on that stitch. We're just going to leave it as it is. Now chain 1 and turn and slip stitch into the first 2 stitches. So that's the first slip stitch, second slip stitch. Chain 2, place a half double crochet on the next stitch. And then 1 half double crochet on every stitch until the end. Now you're going to chain 2 and turn, place a half double crochet on the first stitch, half double crochet on the second stitch, chain 2, half double crochet into that third stitch, and then just slip stitch onto the next one. So if you see, you have a little bat wing pattern that's created. Now you're going to leave a tail, snip your yarn off, and just pull it right through. So once you're done, you should have 2 little bat wings that look like this. So now once you're done, you're going to have to sew these in place. And the way we're going to do that is like this on one side and like this on the other side. So just below the ears, you can sew it on. If you want these to be a little stiffer, you can mix white glue and water in a 1:1 ratio and just brush it on and let it dry for about half an hour. These will become much stiffer. So this completes our little project. So your little bat stands too. And if you flip it over, you have your little vampire and your vampire stands too. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, please share it with all your friends. Comment down below, let me know what you want to see next, and subscribe to the channel. Until next time, bye-bye.